Now I'd like to talk a little bit about the Aspera Command Line Client. The Aspera Command Line Client can be used with two of Aspera's applications, Faspex and Shares, in order to provide a command line interface for functionality that is normally only available through the API or through the web user interface. And so you can do things like you can send a Faspex package via email with a single command on the command line. Or if you have repetitive commands, for example, you could write a shell script and send multiple packages through Faspex. Or you could use it to copy files from share servers to a local machine, something like that. It's quite useful for people who don't want to go through all the effort of using the API programmatically, but want some level of simple automation for a repetitive task. It's also probably appropriate for system administrators or people who are comfortable with the command line. So how is it used? You can download the binary from our Aspera website, and to run it, you just type Aspera and then the command. It has a stacked command structure, so Aspera, the name of the product, and then the command you want to execute. For example, Aspera Faspex send would be the command that you would issue to send a Faspex package. So you can say things like Aspera help Faspex, which gives you all the available options for the Faspex commands. And you can do the same for shares or any subcommand. When you use the Aspera command line client, you'll need to have some authentication credentials, and those credentials will be for a Faspex server or for a shares server. You can specify it on the command line, or the password can also be specified in an environment variable for the shell which is running the Aspera command. That gives it a little more security. In order to debug any problems you might have with the command line interface, you can use -v as a verbose argument, which will show you a lot more of the details about how the Aspera command line client is using the APIs in order to implement its functionality. And will spit out a lot of information useful if you're trying to learn how to use those APIs